we want to thank Alyssa Logan Walker, who just played for us. Piano player, Brayden. Are you ready to go? Hi, I'm Pastor Jeff. I'm from Big Trees Community Bible Church, just up the road a little bit in Arnold. And we are so thankful for the invitation to bring our choir down here to sing for you today. And they're going to be performing again tomorrow morning during the worship service at 10:30. But we thought this would be a great opportunity for us to not only get a little more practice, but also to hopefully bless you in this Christmas season with some wonderful Christmas music. I don't know about you, but I love the Christmas season, and the music of the Christmas season is just the best. And so we're just so happy that you're here and looking forward to doing what we can do. So Joan Bowersox is at the piano, and Paul is going to come, and he will be leading us. So welcome. Thank you for the opportunity.
Before we get started, I want to give you a little more background on how this event came about. We've been practicing for months. It takes us that long. But we've been practicing for months, and during that time, we get maybe a fourth practice and three quarters talking, just gossiping. Well, some of our ladies got together and said, we're thinking about cookies. And what, as you see in the back of the room, how can we have another cookie splurge? So the 25% of our choir here tonight is from the Diggins. They said, I know, we can put an event on and have more cookies. So that's why we're here. One other thing though, I do want to suggest. We're not here to perform, we're here to share our music that we sing to our Lord and Savior. And with that, we hope you enjoy it. You can enjoy singing with us when we can. With that, I think we'll try to get going. Is that right?
Thank you. walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end.
Thank you. O come, come to the manger of Christ. Herein lies the mystery. God came to the earth as a baby. At long last, the fullness of time has come.
The waiting, longing world sees the promise. God comes to us in a most unexpected way.
The years of silence are over. Ancient prayers, long whispered in dark rooms and on bright mountaintops, are answered tonight in a helpless infant.
Angel announcements, previously unseen stars in the heavens. Yes, in an instant the world has changed. Glory fills the air. Shepherds and kings, rich and poor alike, are drawn to the manger and are welcomed. Only God could have orchestrated this gathering.
Now, under those stars, as Mary looked at her newborn baby, she could still hear the echo of the angel's greeting. Don't be afraid. You are highly favored. She was a recipient of God's grace, chosen to bear his son.
And this little one, he was the Messiah, the Son of the Most High. Suddenly, Mary understood something she could not have understood before. Every question, every doubt, and every fear had one answer tonight, and he was right here in her arms.
Announced to the shepherd. A Savior has been born. He is Christ, the Lord, the Anointed One.
Prophets, priests, and kings are all anointed. This baby is all three. He is the priest who brings us to the Father.
He is the prophet who is the embodiment of truth.
He is the King who leads the way.
And he is Jesus, the sweet holy child born in a manger, come to deliver us from our sins.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
From eternity past, Jesus was.
Jesus, the one who would say, "Truly, I tell you, before Abraham was, I was born."
Jesus, the one who would say to the Father, "Glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world began." He is perfect child of heaven, the lovely, pure, gracious gift to humankind.
He is born the Holy Child, laying the old gold lamp by spirit.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, Magi came from the east and arrived in Jerusalem asking, "Where is he who has been born the King of Jews? For we saw his star in the east and have come to worship him."
There were kings searching for the eternal King of all kings to pay homage to him and to bring gifts. They expected to find him in a palace, or perhaps the great temple in Jerusalem.
But instead, the star led them on until they came to the place where Joseph and Mary, staying with Jesus, they were there, they entered, fell down, and worshipped him. Question of every longing heart would be answered by the birth of a baby in a humble manger. The question, is there room enough for me?
The answer would come in the poverty of a manger. There the lowly would find their welcome, for only in the ordinary surroundings of a stable would shepherds dare to enter.
And for those seekers who would leave their comforts to find the promise, the answer came. There is room for anyone willing to come.
Yes, the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and full of truth.
By which we could know him, he chose the name Jesus, a name as common and as approachable as anyone could imagine.
The King of all kings, the Lord of all lords, was born in a manger. He was the baby who would be given the name above all names. He was the high and holy one clothed in human flesh, the author of life. He was the Savior, the Messiah.
Jesus, you shall call his name Jesus.
Thank you.
nothing more to say. And you can be thankful for that because I'm a preacher. So, I'm not going to do that today. But doesn't that beautifully express the Christmas season and what it's all about?
We're going
to do some Christmas carols, and then guess what? There's going to be some food. There's going to be some cookies. I just want to make sure we get our priorities straight here. You know what's coming. But from the choir, Merry Christmas. We hope that you enjoy this time. Now you can show us up. Okay.